Number 58. A mordant is a substance that combines with the dye to produce a sable fixed color in a dyed fabric. Calcium acetate is used as a mordant. It is prepared by the reaction of acetic acid with calcium hydroxide, and it is this equation, right? They said that the reaction is with acetic acid and calcium hydroxide. So here are your two reactants, right? One has to be acetic acid, the other one's got to be calcium hydroxide. So this is the one that has calcium in it, and calcium hydroxide is one of your strong bases, which you guys should memorize. So this is calcium hydroxide, and then this is the acetic acid. What mass of calcium hydroxide, CaOH, is required to react with the acetic acid in 25.0 mils of a solution having a density of 1.065 grams per mil and containing 58.0% acetic acid by mass? Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to rewrite this because I can't really work with that if it's, you know, so small over there. But just like we said before, this is the acetic acid, right? And we're combining it with the calcium hydroxide. And this is going to yield the calcium acetate. And then water. So basically, this is an acid-base reaction. I have acetic acid with calcium hydroxide, and calcium hydroxide is one of your strong bases. So it's just a acid-base reaction. Okay, so let's list everything that we know underneath our balanced equation. And I say it's balanced already because I already see that they gave me coefficients in the front. Usually, if they give you coefficients in the front, you can already assume that it's balanced, but always, you can always pause the video or just check an equation to make sure that it's balanced. But this one is balanced. Okay. So, let's see. The question is asking for what mass of calcium hydroxide. Mass is in grams, so I know that this is what I'm searching for. I'm looking for how many grams of calcium hydroxide, and let's see all the information that they gave us. Now, they're telling us that it's reacting with acetic acid, and there's a total of 25.0 mils of a solution. Remember, guys, a solution means a total. Okay, so total is a solution. The total, you know, mixture is a solution. And they tell us that we have a density value, and it's contained, that solution is 58.0% acetic acid by mass. When you see this, guys, when you see a percentage and they say by mass, you know that you're doing a percent mass formula, okay? So I know that we're going to have to use this equation. So remember this, right? Percent mass is just a fancy way for saying part over whole, right? Any percentage is a part over whole. We've done tons of problems dealing with percent masses. And keep in mind that solution, just like we said before, is a total, right? So the solution here would be the total or the whole. And then the solute is the part, right? Now they're telling us that it's acetic acid in the solution. So you can basically say that this solute, the part, is the acetic acid. So I'm going to say that this is the CH3CO2H, okay? And that's the mass. If it's percent by mass, that means that the top number and the bottom number should be in a mass value. And I look here and I see that my density is in grams, so it's got to be grams over grams. Okay, now, let's see. Basically, they gave us a percent mass, right? They gave us 58.0%, and they're telling us that the total solution is 25 mils. So they gave us information for the solution, right? They told us that this was 25 mils. But hold the phone here, right? If I can't use this 25 mils because I need a mass value. I need a gram value. So the first thing I have to do is I have to use the density to convert from a milliliter to a gram value, right? How do you go from a volume to a mass? You got to use the density. So that's the first thing that we're going to do here. Remember, D equals M over V, right? They gave us the density. They told us the density was 1.065 grams per mil. And they told us that we had 25 mils, right, of the solution. So I have a D value. I have a volume. So I can just solve for the mass. If I just rearrange this formula, right, it would be mass equals density times volume, just for, you know, calculation and ease of the video. But you could use the same formula and just solve for M on top. That's fine with me. So let's see here. My mass equals the density, which is 1.065. Now, I'm not going to put in the units because I check before to see if my units match, but the volume unit of the density is mils, and the volume unit of my volume is mils. So you have the same volume unit, so it's okay to use. Okay, and let's see. The mass of this solution, remember, we're finding the solution number on the bottom. 1.065 times 25. I get 26.625 grams, and that is of the solution, the total, because the 25 mils came from the whole solution. So the 26.625 grams comes from the whole solution as well. But now I have this, right? I have this now. This is standard. So I can solve for my acetic acid mass. So let's do it. I'll put it on this side. 58.0 equals something over something times 100. The bottom number is the one that we found, 26.625, and then the X is going to be on the top, the mass of the acetic acid. So I'm just going to divide by 100, divide by 100 just to get the 100 out of there. So this would be 0.58 equals 26.625. X over 26.625. And then this is cross multiplication. So I can just solve for X, right? 0.58 times that number. I get 15.4425. Okay. And that's grams now of the acetic acid. So that's the grams of the CH3CO2H. Okay. Now there's a lot of stuff going on here. So I would highly suggest that you pause the video because we did all this math basically to just get the mass of the acetic acid. So I'm going to write that number underneath the mass of the acetic acid. I have that number, so I'm just going to say that this is 15.4425 grams. And the rest of this goes bye-bye. I know, it's so sad. There's a lot of math that you have to do to get through this, but if you need, pause the video, but all this is going bye-bye. 3, 2, 1, bye. So sad. But now, look what we have. We have a mass of the acetic acid, and I need to go to another compound in a balanced equation. That's the stoichiometry part. If you have information of one compound and you need to go to another compound via a balanced equation, all you're going to do is use ratios. And the overall flow diagram, we've seen this time and time again, is this, right? It's the grams to moles to moles to grams, grams to moles to moles to grams. The red or the A's are generic for the starting, and the blues or the B's is what you're ending with. That's why I color coded red and blue. So we have a gram value, so that's, we're starting over here. All we got to do is just cater this flow diagram to what we're starting with. So I have 15.4425 grams of, I'm going to just erase this, pull this a little bit out just so that I have room. Maybe I'll pull this a little bit this way. Perfect. CH3CO2H. I can go get the moles of the CH3, CO2H, and then there I could get the moles of the compound that I want, right? That's the calcium hydroxide. And then from there, I could just get the grams of calcium hydroxide. Okay. So it looks like three steps now. Let's just do the ratios. Start with what you're given. 15.4425. And now this is grams of CH3CO2H. Now remember, if we're flowing or we're using a flow diagram, this is all ratios. So all we have to do is multiply by a ratio, work with the units first, and then go back and put your numbers. You don't want grams of acetic acid, so that goes on the opposite side, on the bottom in this case. And just look ahead to see where you're going. I'm going to moles of that. So it's the same compound. Okay. So my units are there, but now I need to know what the numbers are that go on the top or the bottom. Well, this is a mole to gram conversion of the same compound. Moles to grams or grams to moles is always a periodic table conversion. So I have to go on my periodic table and find out what the mass is of acetic acid, right? You have, remember, be careful, you have, and maybe I'll just put it up here, right? You have a total of two carbons, right? You have a total of four hydrogens, and you have two oxygens, right? If you combine them all, because it kind of makes it just easier. CH3CO2H is the same thing as saying C2H4O2. And remember, if you're using the periodic table, you have one mole. The mass number that you're going to find goes on the bottom. In this case, it's going to go with the grams. So let's see. I have a total of two carbons, 2 times 12.01. I have a total of four hydrogens. Okay. And then I got a total of two oxygens. So I get roughly 60.052. Right? If I just like pull this away, pull this in. Perfect. Everything is accounted for here, so I could cancel out the units and I keep flowing. Get out of the habit of, you know, getting an actual number for this and then moving forward. Don't be scared. You guys got this. Just keep flowing. All right? Because we didn't get to the answer yet. The answer's all the way over here. So multiply by a ratio, right? Put the unit that you don't want on the opposite side. So mole of CH3CO2H, and then just look and see what's coming up next. Now we're transferring over to the other compound. Now it's a mole-to-mole conversion of two different compounds. This, you use the balanced equation. And what I mean by when you're using the balanced equation, all we got to do is look at the coefficients, the big numbers, in front of those compounds in the balanced equation. So for example, here is my acetic acid, right? And the number in front, the big number in front, is a 2. So that means that I have 2 moles of acetic acid. The 2 goes with the acetic acid. But now if I look at my calcium hydroxide, right? I don't see a number in the front, right? There's no number here. So what does that mean? There's a secret 1 here. So I'll just say I have 1 of those. And that's the end for this conversion. These are pretty easy. Cancel out the units that you can. And now we have one more step. We got to go from moles to grams. So times by a ratio. Put the unit you don't want on the opposite side. Look ahead to see what you're going to be putting on the top. In this case, it's grams of the CaOH. And it's a mole and gram, or gram to mole conversion, of the same compound, just like before. This is the periodic table. And remember, with the periodic table, you always have one mole. So wherever the word mole is, you put a 1 there. The mass is the number on the periodic table in the grams. So I have one calcium, two oxygens, and two hydrogens. So 40.08 plus 2 times 16 plus 2 times 1.008. I get 74.096. And now the units cancel. And now we finally have our answer because this is what we wanted. We wanted grams of calcium hydroxide, right? Set it right here as a little reminder. And then that's what the question was asking. That's why I like to put down what I'm asking for, because I don't really like to go back to the question. I like to just have everything in front of me here and, you know, look back to that. So now anything in the denominator, if you do this in one shot, denominator divide, DD, okay? But you could multiply all the numerators, multiply all the denominators, and then do the division at the end. That's fine with me. You'll get the same answer. So 15.4425 divided by 60.052. Since the next number 2 is in the denominator, I'll press divide. And then times 74.096. Okay. And now I'm going to just look back, and I see that this number has 3 sig figs, this number has 4, and this number has 3 sig figs. So if we needed to do sig fig rules, my answer should have 3, the lowest number, because we did just all multiplying and dividing. So this should be 9.53 grams of the calcium hydroxide. And that is it. So in order to make this reaction work, right, with 25 mils of a solution having 58% mass of acetic acid, you would need to weigh out 9.53 grams of calcium hydroxide to make a complete reaction. And that's it. So guys, what do you think? Hopefully this helped. Let me know in the comments. Give this video a thumbs up. And if you want, subscribe to the channel. That would be great. Gets the word out there all over the world that this free cervix exists. Say that 20 times fast. I can never say it correctly, but you guys get the point. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next lesson, okay? All right, have a great day. Bye-bye.